Hello everyone, this is Ananya Sajwan, and today in this video I'll be discussing about encryption and decryption using the Blowfish algorithm. So the Blowfish algorithm is an important topic in the course Information Security Analysis and Audit. So let's get into the video. So firstly, I'll be discussing about encryption and decryption in general. So in the fields of information security and cryptography, encryption can be defined as the process of encoding a message or information in a way that only authorized parties can access it, and those who are not authorized cannot access it. So there are different encryption standards available. The first one is Data Encryption Standard, or DES, which is now obsolete. The second one is Advanced Encryption Standard, or AES. The third one is RSA, which is the original public key algorithm and is popular. And the last one is OpenPGP. So let's see in layman terms, how does encryption work? So here we have a sender and a recipient. So the sender wants to send this plain text to the recipient, but wants to ensure the security of the plain text and ensure that it is not modified in any manner. So how do we do this? So there are different keys used to encrypt and decrypt messages. So the encryption key is applied to the plain text, which converts it to a ciphertext. This ciphertext is then sent from the sender to the recipient. The ciphertext is decrypted using the decryption keys, and the original plain text is obtained. So this encryption decryption process, which forms the ciphertext, ensures that the plain text is not modified in any way and ensures security. Next, let's see the different types of encryption algorithms available. So the first one is triple DES encryption. Though this algorithm is slowly being phased out, triple DES is still a dependable hardware encryption solution for financial services and other industries. The next one is RSA encryption. RSA is a public key encryption algorithm and is the standard for sending encryption data over the internet. The next one is Advanced Encryption Standards, or AES. It is an algorithm which is trusted as the standard by US government and many other reputed organizations. AES is considered resistant to all attacks except the brute force attack. So here we have a list of few popular algorithms. The Two-Fish Encryption algorithm is one. The Blowfish encryption algorithm is another, which we will be discussing further. IDEA encryption algorithm, MD5 encryption algorithm, and HMAC encryption algorithm. So this is about the different types of encryption algorithms available. So let's go into the Blowfish encryption algorithm in detail. So Blowfish is an encryption technique designed by Bruce Schneier in 1993. It was designed as an alternative to the DES encryption technique. It is significantly faster than DES and provides a very good encryption rate too. Blowfish algorithm is one of the first secure block ciphers and is not subject to any patents. So it is freely available in the public for anyone to use. Coming to some specifications, the block size in Blowfish encryption algorithm is 64 bits. The key size varies from 32 bits to 448 bits. The number of subkeys is 80, and these subkeys are stored in an array which is called the P array. The number of rounds in which encryption and decryption takes place is 16, and the number of substitution boxes is 4. So here we see a flowchart which details the entire encryption process. Basically, there are three main steps. The first step is generation of subkeys. So 18 subkeys are needed for both encryption and decryption process, and the same subkeys are used in both the processes. So in the second step, we have initialization of substitution boxes. 4 substitution boxes, or S boxes, are needed for both encryption as well as decryption, with each S box having 256 entries, each of 32 bits. The step 3 is encryption, which consists of two parts, rounds and post-processing. So each round takes inputs of plain text from previous round and corresponding subkeys. So here we see we have round 0 and the corresponding subkey, which is P of 0. So in round 1, we see the plain text of the previous round, which is round 0, will be taken along with the subkey of the current round, which is PO1. And this goes on till round 15. And from round 0 to round 15, we have a total of 16 rounds. After this is the post-processing step. So the output after 16 rounds is processed accordingly using various functions such as XOR functions, modulus functions, and addition functions. After that, the 64-bit ciphertext is generated. Next, so this is a very similar flowchart, but this is for decryption. There is a slight difference here. So again, there are three main steps. The first two steps are common: generation of subkeys. As I mentioned, there are 18 subkeys needed for both encryption and decryption. The step two is initialization of the substitution boxes, which is 4 S boxes. And the third stage is decryption. The decryption function consists of, again, two parts: rounds and post-processing. Here we see the only difference here is that the subkeys are used in reverse. So for round 0, we have P of 17, which is the last subkey. So we go, we take the subkeys in reverse, and after 16 rounds, we have the post-processing stage, which gives the 64-bit plain text, which converted from the 64-bit ciphertext. Next, coming to the various applications of Blowfish algorithm. So file and disk encryption software like CryptoForge, CryptoDisk, etc. use Blowfish algorithm. And this algorithm is also used in password management tools like 1Password, Keyring Mini, Passwords Plus, etc. to encrypt and store passwords. It is also used by various email encryption software like ALOC, SecuMail, Cypherus, and Z1 Secure Mail Gateway. In the recent times, Blowfish algorithm has been used in research papers to develop enhanced image encryption technologies. So let's see one of these applications. Here we have image encryption using the Blowfish algorithm. So we have the original image captured and the randomized image. And this undergoes a process called image hybridization. And an input image is generated from this process. The input image is feeded into the Blowfish encryption model, which after post-processing gives the cipher image. The cipher image can be stored or it can be transmitted. So after storing or transmitting, the cipher image is put into the Blowfish decryption model. After the decryption model does its work, we get the decrypted image. The decrypted image is again put into an image separation process, which gives us the original image. So this is one of the recent developments in Blowfish algorithm, and there are many research papers available on the internet for this. Some of the best practices for encryption which need to be followed, whether you're using Blowfish encryption algorithm or any other encryption algorithm, these points need to be kept in mind. Firstly, you should know the laws. When it comes to safeguarding personal information, organizations need to adhere to many privacy-related regulations. The top regulations that impact many organizations include FERPA, HIPAA, HITECH, COPPA, etc. These are some of the top regulations available currently. The second point is to assess the data properly. Entities need to perform a data risk assessment and implement encryption if the evaluation indicates that encryption would be a reasonable and appropriate safeguard. And this is why assessing data is very important. The third point is determining the required or needed level of encryption. This is also an important step that organizations must adhere to. So the fourth point is be mindful of sensitive data transfers and remote access. This is because communicating or sending data over the internet needs transport layer security, which is a protocol for transmitting data over the network. And the last point is note fine print details. Regulatory compliance entails much more than simply password protecting any office workstation. It requires proper encryption to protect data at rest when stored on systems or any removable media device. So here we have come to the conclusion of this presentation. the encryption and decryption are important aspects of all organizations for basically four main reasons: authentication, privacy, regulatory compliance, and security. Data encryption using Glowfish algorithm is a common and effective security method and is a good choice for protecting an organization's information. But the real challenge lies in deciding which techniques an internet security expert should employ that best suits an organization's situation. You cannot apply the same algorithm in every situation. The algorithm application depends from situation to situation. So Glowfish algorithm is an effective algorithm in various domains in this industry, and it helps ensure network security via encryption and decryption. So here I have a code, which is the Glowfish encryption algorithm in Python. Here we can see the P array, which contains all the subkeys. This S is the substitution boxes. There are a total of 4 substitution boxes, as we can see. So coming to, this is the key array, and here we have the calculate and encrypt function. So the encrypt function calls the calculate function. The calculate function is applicable for each round. So as I mentioned, there are a total of 16 rounds in both encryption and decryption. So the encrypt function calls the calculate function 16 times, and it uses the previous round's plain text with the current round's subkey. So the same procedure happens in the decrypt also. Only thing, as I mentioned, the subkeys are used in reverse. The same calculate function is called, but the subkeys are used in reverse. This is the main function where we enter the data to be encrypted, and we print whether the data is a valid input or not. This code here, which I have written, is applicable only for integer and integer data. Currently, you can modify the code to make it applicable to strings or any other type of data. So let us run this code. So here it's asking me to enter the data to be encrypted. So let me just enter a number. So I've entered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and it shows that it is a valid input. The encrypted data is as shown after all the rounds are completed, and it also shows the hex value over here and the data after decryption, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, which is the same thing which I had input. So this shows that the Glowfish algorithm works correctly. For further use, I have also uploaded the code to my GitHub, and I'll provide the link in the description of this video. You can check out the code and you can edit the code according to your suiting. You can try to run the code and see the output for yourself. It will help you better understand the Glowfish algorithm, and I have also uploaded the PPT for further understanding. So hope you enjoyed this video. That's it from me. Thank you.